biodigester materials you must use in your next biodigester construction at all costs. The materials listed in this video is what has led to my business to construct over 1,000 biodigesters in Ghana. The last but one biodigester construction material will take your next biodigester construction to the next level. Let's get into the video now. The first biodigester construction material must have is your blocks, preferably quarry dust ones. Blocks can be used for various types of biodigester construction. Hybrid biodigesters, where you have the slabs on top of blocks to elevate the digester, or using them to reinforce a digester already constructed with prefabricated slabs. The second material is your prefabricated slabs, and these are slabs that give you the added advantage of constructing biodigesters in really small spaces and in tight corners.
If you are using the slabs, just within a day, 4 or 5 hours time, you have finished your digesters and then you are gone. So basically, that's the advantage when it comes to the precast slabs. If a slab is done well, I've done a video of how to cast precast slabs. I'm going to leave the link at the top there. You can go have a look at it and see how to cast a precast slab. If it's done well, it must contain wire mesh. It must have the quarter rods or iron rod in it, the 3/8 possibly. It must have all the ingredients, and you must use quarry dust and of course only cement to have it cast. That way it becomes firm, and then it should be 2 inches or maybe 2.5 inches, and you are not going to have any problems when you do that.
The third most important material that you will need for your biodigester construction will be your cement. This can be the 32.5R or the 42.5R type of cement. In Ghana, we have a lot of brands in this particular industry, and they are all doing just fine. Iron rods are your next best material for biodigester construction. The 40mm, the 12mm, even the 10, all the way to the quarter rods are fine for casting your top slabs and top covers and your bedding material slabs. Closely linked to the iron rods are the binding wires for holding the iron rods firmly together when you are casting slabs, either for top cover or inside bedding material holder.
Sand.
You will need sand for your construction. The cost aggregate really depends on what's available to you when it comes to the way you are doing the construction. And of course, it's just used to mix the right mixture of mortar for your biodigester construction. Number 7 on my list of biodigester construction material that you need is a set of plumbing materials that you will be needed when it comes to biodigester construction. The 4-inch pipe to be used for two things: inlet pipe and of course the shape pipe that will be connected to the soakaway. You will also need an end cap and clean out for your inspection chamber,
because that's what will go on the top slab, and then it can easily be assessed anytime you want to have a look inside the digester to see whether everything is working well. You can open it and have a look inside. You need a black rubber.
The 8th most important biodigester construction material. This biodigester construction material will take your next biodigester construction to the next level. And this is the biodegradable material, or the coconut fiber, as we have come to know as the name. Other replacement materials are the hay, like a form of elephant grass, usually fed to horses. And saw chippings together with black saw on top of it. The last material for a successful biodigester construction is the mosquito or fiber net that must be placed on the porous slab or the bedding slab before the biodegradable materials are laid and spread evenly on the biodigester bed. Notable mentions in your biodigester construction materials includes the bioenzyme to help aid the biodegradation process.